you tonight, and
great
I so busted you in front of a group.
Yes.
I know where you got that steak, too.
It's
you
about
got that
stolen.
Steak from Del Frisco's, didn't
yes,
you?
Yes, I did.
All right. Good to see you tonight.
See you.
Welcome to Hannity. So we are now 439 days into the Trump-Russia collusion witch hunt, and still nothing, zero evidence that Donald Trump or his campaign did anything wrong. Now, the president rightfully is calling out Mueller and his extreme conflicts of interest and his blatant political bias in a huge way. Now, the president's attorney, Rudy Giuliani, will set the record tonight with the very latest. Also, if Robert Mueller is really concerned with Russia collusion, well, I'll happily be glad to point him in the right direction. We've got all the evidence he needs. In fact, there are many real examples of Hillary Clinton, Adam Schiffless Schiff, and other top Democrats happily colluding with Russia before, during, and after the 2016 election. We have a great tape. We'll lay it on the table tonight. And also, so many important topics that we've got to cover. Jim Comey, he may be headed back to Capitol Hill. The president is now pushing forward with a strong plan on immigration, which is now an important issue. 98 days we are away from these important midterm elections. The media is really actually rooting against America's strong economy. And we've got that tape. All right, sit tight, stay tuned, buckle up. It's time for tonight's very important news-breaking, multi-pronged opening monologue. It is the worst example of political persecution in U.S. history. It was supposed to be a deep dive into how Russia was attempting to meddle and cause chaos in our presidential election. Instead, for months, special counsel Robert Mueller, he's been searching for something, anything, to malign the president and all his allies. Well, now the special counsel's judgment, political prejudice, is in the spotlight today. This weekend, the president tweeted, quote, is Robert Mueller ever going to release his conflicts of interest with respect to President Trump, including the fact that we had a very nasty, contentious business relationship? I turned him down to head the FBI one day before his appointment as special counsel. And Jim Comey is his close friend. And he continued also, why is Mueller only appointing angry Democrats, some of whom actually work for crooked Hillary, like, well, Jeanine Ray and others, including himself, have worked for Obama. Why isn't Mueller looking at all the criminal activity, the real Russian collusion on the Democratic side, Podesta, dossier? The president's absolutely right. On this program, we've been right, and we have long called out Mueller, his merry band of Trump-hating and corrupt Democratic donors for what are extreme conflicts of interest. In fact, Mueller's team is made up of investigators and lawyers who have almost exclusively donated to Obama, Hillary, Democrats. They couldn't find one Republican, not one, even an independent. Now, we're talking about tens of thousands of dollars to candidates like Kirsten Gillibrand, Barack Obama, Hillary Clinton herself. And we have called out Comey's cozy relationship with Robert Mueller. Now, the two long-term time bureaucrats were once referred to as brothers in arms. Now, given all of this anti-Trump bias, should anyone in this country really be surprised? Sadly, we have a two-tiered system of justice. Mueller is more than happy to obsess about a pointless meeting at Trump Tower between Donald Trump Jr. Paul Manafort goes on trial tomorrow. When is Hillary going on trial? And a Russian lawyer. It resulted in absolutely nothing. It's a 2005 tax case. Had nothing to do with Russia. Nothing. But no investigation into, let's see, Congressman Adam Schiff. Now, we actually have the tape. Remember, he was duped into having a conversation with the Russian pranksters who promised him embarrassing political dirt, naked pictures and everything of Donald Trump. Collusion. Listen for yourself.
He was in Moscow in November 2013. He met with a journalist and...
Well, she's poor journalist. But anyway, she became famous because of Putin is her godfather.
Okay, Putin's godfather. Okay.
She also known as a person who provide girls for escort for oligarchs, and she met with Trump and she brought him one hour Russian girl, celebrity Olga Buzova, who also known as a person with a strange reputation.
Olga, and how do you spell her name?
Olga Buzova.
And what's the nature of the compromise?
Well, there were pictures of naked Trump.
Mm-hmm. And so Putin was made aware of the availability of the compromising material?
Yes, of course.
Thank you very much. We will be back in touch with you through our staff to make arrangements to obtain these materials for our committee and for the FBI. And I appreciate your reaching out to us.
Naked pictures of Trump. It was Russia collusion. Oh, the big elephant in the room. Clinton campaign. Robert Mueller. Listen up. We found collusion. Call Schiffler Schiff immediately. All right. Remember, it was Clinton and the DNC. They funneled money through a law firm, Perkins Coie, to a consulting firm, Fusion GPS, to fund a foreign spy, Christopher Steele. Why? Because he had Russian contacts that made up Russian lies, the now infamous dirty dossier that, by the way, was never verified, corroborated, and has been debunked. The Clinton campaign used these bought and paid for Russian lies in two ways. First, it was used to shape the Clinton campaign's message. And according to a report from the House Intel Committee, quote, a person whose name was redacted led regular briefings that contain Steele's information for senior Clinton campaign staff. And that included campaign manager Robbie Mook, campaign chairman Johnny Podesta. And second, the dirty dossier was actually shopped around to various high-ranking government officials and, of course, your corrupt media, all in an effort to malign the Trump campaign before Election Day, to lie to you. And that included senior DOJ official Bruce Orr, whose wife was working with Christopher Steele at Fusion GPS. She was helping to make up all these lies. And then the CIA director turned MSNBC hack, John Brennan, also reportedly leaked the contents of the dossier to then Senator Harry Reid. Also, Brennan, by the way, was involved in this, who then went public with the information. And of course, there's also the director of national intelligence, James Clapper. It was Brennan who I was talking about before. Clapper allegedly leaked the dossier to CNN, fake news, which now is his employer. And let's not forget the major role the phony dossier played with the FISA warrant application against Trump and the campaign associated Trump's Carter Page during and after the campaign. Four separate warrants, the bulk of information coming from the phony Russian dossier that Hillary paid for. Where's the investigation into this collusion? Mr. Mueller, where are you? The Clinton campaign paid a former spy and used Russian lies to lie to the American people, steal an election, get a warrant to spy on Americans using an unverified, uncorroborated Hillary Clinton bought and paid for political document. Nobody told the FISA court judges ever in the original application, subsequent applications, and disseminated what was false, untrue, propaganda, disinformation to rig an election, a presidential election. Now, given the rampant bias from Team Mueller and this two-tiered system of justice at play here, is it any surprise that President Trump's attorney, Rudy Giuliani, who will join us in a few minutes, is urging his client not to participate in any interview with Mueller? If he did, he would be crazy. That's a bad idea. You can't trust these people. They're corrupt.
Are you now yes or a no on a sit down between the president and Robert Mueller?
Well, two things. First, I'm no on a sit down until we get ironed out exactly what they want to do. And then the process is we have five co-counsel, senior people. We'll advise the president. He decides. Mm-hmm. And he's always leaned in favor of doing it.
Well, what are you telling him about that? What advice?
Right now, I'm telling him no way.
And as we speak, Rudy Giuliani will join us in just a moment as crafting a report to rebut any kind of negative findings from Team Mueller. And of course, we know Trump-Russia collusion is a total hoax. Still, many on the left in your media are rolling out recent actions of one-time Trump attorney Michael Cohen as some kind of huge smoking gun against President Trump. Even Michael Cohen himself, if they would do their jobs, they're lazy and overpaid, has denied the accusations of collusion. He did it in testimony on Capitol Hill in 2017. He said, quote, given my proximity to the president of the United States as a candidate, let me also say that I never saw anything, not a hint of anything, that demonstrated his involvement in Russian interference or election or any form of Russia collusion. Let me say it again. It's time for this witch hunt to end. We are now more than 14 months into this politically motivated fishing expedition, all designed to malign the president that you, the American people, voted for. If the deep state, your corrupt media, and all these elites had their way, well, he never would have been president. That's why they rigged the investigation into Hillary to save her. Now Donald Trump is the leader of the free world. His decisions impact the lives of literally billions of people every day. And this collusion, lie, distraction is hurting the country. And frankly, abroad, it's hurting us as well. It needs to stop. And meanwhile, breaking tonight, former deep state Trump hater, fired FBI director Jimmy Comey. Well, he may be headed back to Capitol Hill. Bye bye, Jim. And House Republicans are reportedly pushing to interview Comey over his decision making during the 2016 election. Remember, he was one of the officials to sign off on the Pfizer warrant against the Trump campaign associate, despite admitting the dossier, he said, was salacious and unverified. But then he had already signed off on it. We also have breaking news on the immigration front tonight. Over the weekend, the president tweeted this: I'd be willing to shut down the government if the Democrats do not give us the votes for border security, which includes the wall. Must get rid of lottery, catch and release, and finally go to a system of immigration that is merit-based. We need great people coming into our country. And today, the president doubled down on that tweet. Watch this.
My administration is working hard to pass border security legislation, improve vetting, and establish a merit-based immigration system, which the United States needs very, very importantly, very badly. As far as the border is concerned, and personally, if we don't get border security, after many, many years of talk within the United States, I would have no problem doing a shutdown. It's time we had proper border security.
Secure the borders. And as the president continues to push seriously for a wall to protect our country and a common sense merit-based immigration system, well, your friends in the Democratic Party, their friends in the media, they're playing political games with America's strong economy. Last week, great economic news. GDP grows at a whopping 4.1% rate. And despite this great news, our robust, healthy economy, we now have the largest labor participation rate ever, millions fewer on food stamps, and, oh, 4 million new jobs. Isn't that great? Now, the media is spinning. This is bad news. Huh, only the media. Take a look.
Here's the thing, with the economy booming like it is now, at least in GDP terms, and low unemployment rates among minorities and all that good news, he's still in the low 40s. And what's he going to be when we have our recession in 2 years?
There was sort of an urgency in the president's voice that bordered on almost pulling a muscle, trying to pat yourself on the back. There is a sense of where you overhype something, and there were so many times in those remarks that it felt overhyped on how he was talking about the economy.
We've accomplished an economic turnaround of historic proportions.
Yeah.
Hold on. Can we play that again? Anybody that just goes on a Google machine can see that you showed part that the economy, 08 was here, went up, and then it's been a steady, slow, gradual economic increase.
Oh, the vapors every morning, 6 to 9. Oh. Can't help it. As we march toward the most important midterms of our life, buckle up, get ready. The rhetoric coming from the media, Democrats, and their friends on the left, it is going to get more insane, more negative, and more ridiculous. I'm telling you, you better get ready for the polls. Everybody's going to be smeared. Buckle up. And guess what? The future of your country is at stake. The Democrats win in November. This is their agenda. Take a close look. Right there. They want to rescind. They want their crumbs back. They want to rescind the tax cuts. They won't say it. They tell everyone to be quiet. But they want to impeach the president. Just don't tell the people. And of course, they love their Obamacare. Keep your doctor, keep your plan. I bet a lot of you are paying so much less, right? And they want to block Judge Kavanaugh. And of course, they want to end all legitimate, important investigations into the deep state. And yeah, they want open borders. We know they want open borders. They want to eliminate ICE. In 99 days, you, the people, will decide if the Trump agenda stops. Do you want that to happen? What did you vote for in 2016? There's a lot on the line here. There's no positive agenda. Joining us now, the author of the hit new book. It has been number one for over a week, The Russia Hoax. And that's the illicit scheme to clear Hillary Clinton and frame Donald Trump. Fox News legal analyst Greg Jarrett, the author of another huge best-selling book, The Case Against Impeaching Trump. Harvard professor who's not really loved where he is right now on some island. I won't want to mention where because everyone's attacking him, Alan Dershowitz, and criminal civil rights attorney David Shona is with us. All right, let's start with the so-called Trump Tower meeting and compare it to Adam Schiff's Schiff. And he thinks he's talking to a Russian about naked pictures of Trump, and he's excited about it. He's talking to a Russian collusion.
Right. It's not collusion to have either of those conversations in the Trump Tower meeting or Adam Schiff. It's not a violation of the Federal Campaign Election Act because foreign nationals are allowed to volunteer information in an American campaign. Some have said, oh, it's a conspiracy to defraud the government. No, it's not. That requires dishonesty, deceit, trickery, and craft. Mm-hmm. No application here. Some have said, and these are law professors who have said this, well, there could be honest services fraud. No, that requires, according to the Supreme Court, a bribe or a kickback. So, again, collusion's not even a crime
Never
in a political campaign.
Never.
Show me in
it.
The criminal codes where this exists. I have an entire chapter of the book entitled, It's Not a Crime to Talk to a Russian. Hillary Clinton's campaign and Democrats actually talked to more Russians than the contact with the Trump campaign.
Worse than that, they paid for Russian lies. Professor Dershowitz, I know you took great offense on conspiracy TV, MSNBC. Why you punish yourself like that, I have no idea. Nobody's really watching anyway. But the important question is, you have said this. You're not the biggest Donald Trump supporter politically. But to you, this is important because it's about civil liberties, our Constitution. I don't think Professor Dershowitz likes that FISA judges were purposefully lied to and that they gave them false information to obtain a warrant on an American citizen and tried to impact an election. All of these things I think disconcerting.
Well, more than disconcerting, I find them unconstitutional. When members of the Justice Department seek a warrant and deliberately withhold the two most crucial pieces of information, namely that the dossier was paid for by people trying to defeat Donald Trump for president, and withholding the fact that the credibility of the witness who was providing the information may turn on the fact that he claims he has evidence that Donald Trump engaged in these kind of salacious things with a bed and urine. If they had told that to the FISA court, the FISA court would have totally discounted the credibility of this witness. A witness who can come up with that kind of nonsense is not the kind of witness who would justify granting a warrant that would surveil Americans.
What about Rosenstein and Comey? Aren't they supposed to verify it? Aren't they supposed to make sure that the judges are fully informed and they knew that Hillary paid for that?
If they knew that, and they saw the actual application, then they committed a serious violation. And they should be asked why those two pieces of information in particular were willfully and deliberately withheld from the FISA court. Look, the other side says maybe they would have granted the warrant anyway. We know FISA courts grant warrants very easily. There should be a whole revision of the way FISA courts operate. There should be a devil's advocate who is arguing against the granting of the application. But these two pieces of information, I want to hear from Rosenstein and from others, why did they justify withholding those two pieces of information if they knew they existed and they knew that the FISA court would want to know that?
How about we release 19 pages unredacted, David Schoen, of the last warrant that Rod Rosenstein signed off on? Because I hear it's devastating to him and to others. Let the American people see all of it.
Right. That's a key point. Respectfully, Professor Dershowitz, he's right on track, but there's not a question now about what Rod Rosenstein knew. We now know that he signed off on at least the last renewal. And the rules of the FISA court expressly provide that if there's any error, doesn't even have to be a material error, error that must be corrected, and the court must be notified immediately in writing if there was any error or omission, specifically in the rule, from any prior application.
Is it a crime? Judge, why do I think Sean Hannity? I have three great lawyers on the show tonight. Three. Seriously, if I lied to a judge, purposely misled a court, or let's say that I deleted subpoenaed emails, I acid washed my hard drive with bleach bit, and then I had busted up my devices. Do you think any of you three, do you think you could get me out of jail? Professor Dershowitz, you're laughing.
I could get you out of jail. Look, I don't think
the only way you're
going to
get me out is with a cake and a file.
Obstruction of justice. No. I think with a legal brief, I think I can demonstrate to you that neither Mueller's case against Trump nor your case against Hillary Clinton amount to an obstruction of justice.
You don't think that's
what I think we ought not to be criminalized.
They subpoena Sean Hannity. Yeah. And I delete the 33,000 emails. Then I use Bleachbit, Greg. And then I bust up the devices. Let's say I go into Robert Mueller. Robert Mueller recently asked for every witness to hand over their Blackberries and iPhones. And I said, if I ever advise people, bad advice, bad. And I did. They did what Hillary did. And I say, here's the busted up devices.
Obstruction of justice. There was a subpoena. So
would I be arrested?
You would. And it's clear obstruction of justice.
Would you get me out?
Comey admitted in his I'd just leave you there.
I get you.
Comey admitted in his testimony. Nobody pays attention to this. Comey admitted in his testimony Hillary Clinton gave classified documents to people without security clearance. That alone should have
been a crime.
Not to mention the fact that 110
like
classified documents.
Spent a year in jail for
these
pictures?
Are people who did the exact same thing on a smaller scale.
How many people are in
Hillary
your book?
Clinton, and they were prosecuted.
How many people in your book do you identify that did far less?
Six.
Yeah.
Six people.
David Schoen? Last word.
Listen, there are many reasons Mr. Comey has to be brought before Congress, not in a backdoor, off-the-record hearing. Public testimony.
Right.
He may think he's going to get some zingers in. He's got to be examined about the many things in the IG report, about his leaks that are still under investigation by the IG. The fundamental problem here is there is no integrity in the process from Mr. Mueller's team that he picked throughout the process. That's what's fundamentally most offensive.
All right, guys. And Professor Dershowitz, thank you. You're the only one that said you can get me out. Thank you. We'll give an extra plug
for
his book.
I can get you out. I just don't want to get you out.
You know, I hope your book tanks now. You know, that's really horrible. No, I'm only teasing. All right, we have a big interview with the president's attorney, Rudy Giuliani, right in studio. I love your book. I'm kidding. It was a joke. Straight ahead.
Everyone understands.
All right, joining us now, America's mayor and President Trump's attorney, Rudy Giuliani. How are you, sir? Good to see you. By the way, I really hate that you have that ring. That is a Yankees championship World Series ring.
Why do you hate it?
I wish I want one.
Well, you weren't the mayor of New York City when they won. I won four of them.
I was there for the last one when Mariano Rivera.
I should emphasize, I paid for it.
Oh, okay. You probably, yeah. You know, it's funny because remember David Dinkins got in trouble for being at that particular game, the last game when the Yankees won the World Series? All right, I was at that game. I bought my tickets on StubHub.
Yeah.
And he got them for free. You always did.
I have a letter from George Steinbrenner that I treasure. He said, the only politician who paid for his tickets.
Yeah, you have to. Right? Long story. All right, let's stay on business. There's no second meeting here.
It's highly unlikely. I always have to leave the option open as a lawyer in case they come across with something that really startles us or fills some of the things that we feel are important. Had a long talk with John Dow today. I believe we're coming toward the end, so I'm talking to some of the people who are involved in the original part of the investigation. I thank John for all the cooperation he gave them because he puts us in a position where we don't have to cooperate. We gave them 1.4 million documents, 32 witnesses. President Trump has answered every question. And now they're looking at his tweets. To investigate him for
trying to influence
obstruction of justice by tweet.
Yeah.
I prosecuted obstruction of justice. If they're going to do obstruction of justice by tweet to impeach a president, God bless us.
You said maybe you would let him answer a few limited questions on collusion, but not.
I don't want to give them the false impression that given some of the revelations of the last 3 or 4 weeks, we've been driven further away from the idea of answering any questions from them. We don't think they have a legitimate investigation.
Do you think they will subpoena it? Is there going to be a constitutional fight?
Well, then there'll be a constitutional fight. I mean, I think we win it. One of the main ingredients of a
Rudy
constitutional
Giuliani's
fight.
Never I was here when you were mayor. You're not exactly shy when it comes to fighting.
No, and we beat Clinton in the Supreme Court when I was mayor, and I won my own case in the Supreme Court when I argued it. And I have one of the best Supreme Court lawyers in the United States with me. You know him, Jay Sekulow.
Yeah.
39 cases in the Supreme Court.
He's won like 90% of his cases.
You got it. How about unanimously? A lot of them.
I know.
But in any event, that's not to boast. It's to say we got the better part of the argument. You have presidential privilege. He can't be subpoenaed. You have the fact that even if he can be subpoenaed, that if he can come out of some narrow, you have to show particularized need. And as John Dowd's memo of 4 months ago shows, they have no particularized need. They have everything. Let's take an example. Mr. President, why'd you fire Comey? He's already explained it over and over and over again. Hey, but, hey, guys, you either believe it or you don't believe it. But don't think we're suckers. And we're going to put that under oath and you're going to jam him with perjury
trap
because you believe a liar like Comey or one of the other liars.
By the way, they're best buddies.
They are very good friends.
And Robert Mueller was denied the day before he got the special counsel job.
Comey is more discredited than anyone in this investigation.
Let me ask.
He cannot be believed. So if you're telling me you're going to believe Comey's word against the president, then I know you're trying to trap him into perjury.
Do you think what happens if, like, for example, what happens if Mueller decides he wants to take this all the way and subpoena the president of the United States?
Well, we go to the Supreme Court and we find out if he can. Never been decided. The only subpoena to a president that ever happened in the many years of our republic is to Bill Clinton. It was withdrawn. It's never been decided. So we will have a case of what they call first impression, and we will find out. But then we have cases of lesser officials that were subpoenaed and documents that were subpoenaed from them, like the ESPY case. And you always have to show particularized need. If you have to show particularized need for a commerce secretary, a labor secretary, you sure as heck have to show it for a president. Tell me the particularized need. They're going to lose on that. As I said, they're going to say, we want to hear what he said about Flynn. Well, he said about Flynn, I never had that conversation. Comey said he did have the conversation. So why are you calling me in the grand jury for that? Because you want to wrap him with a perjury charge when you couldn't bring a regular charge against him.
Yeah, and the president, interesting, had wanted to talk.
Martha Stewart.
But Martha Stewart did nothing. They didn't get her on any crime.
Well,
this
is Martha Stewart. Who did Martha Stewart? Jim Comey.
Scary. It's scary. If you can't get him on the crime, you're going to get him on
the same thing. Let's get him. It doesn't matter how serious the crime
is. Let's go to Mueller's team.
Let's get a celebrity wig to the wall.
What about the SDNY? This is one you work there.
I love the SDNY.
They're good. They're really good at what they do.
Yeah, I have no objections to them.
Why are they bringing in the CFO of the Trump organization?
A thousand reasons. I've been through, and our lawyers have been through, including our Washington lawyers and our New York lawyers. We have been through every one of the documents they've given us, and they've given us every document relating to President Trump. He is whistle clean in that investigation. That's why we quickly waived the privilege. And the minute Cohen leaked that first conversation between Cohen and the president, where he secretly recorded the president and lied to him and pretty much drove himself out of the bar, I mean the legal bar, we put it out. The minute he said the minute he started putting out stuff about the Cuomo tape, where he went through this horrible subterfuge of hiding his tape recorder or his phone.
Will these be made public, all of them?
All of them will be made public, eventually.
Eventually will. What about the Mueller's team?
And I wish they were made public tonight.
What about the Mueller team? Andrew Weissman, who was excoriated by judges for withholding exculpatory evidence.
Andrew Weissman, having been a longtime prosecutor in the Justice Department, Andrew Weissman would be regarded by many defense lawyers and prosecutors as a disgrace to the, he has had cases reversed. He's been excoriated
by
judges.
The Supreme Court.
He's done something, this might sound like a strange thing, but he's withheld exculpatory evidence. You know what that means? He's got evidence that I'm innocent and he keeps it.
That should be
And
a
he
crime.
Sends an innocent man to jail.
Four Merrill executives went to jail for a year.
He sends
that
an
was
innocent
overturned.
Man to jail. Yeah. You know, that's the nightmare you have as a prosecutor. It was built into me by Bob Morgenthau when I first became, and then by Whitney North Seymour. Yeah, we've got a lot of guilty people to prosecute. Damn it, you don't prosecute an innocent one. And when it's close to the line,
give them the benefit of the doubt.
Silvio Malo, who taught me this, used to say to me, hey, Silvio was a New York guy. He said, hey, you know something? If you let them go, no big problem. They'll be back again.
That's probably true. What about, how does Jeanine Ray, who worked for the Clinton Foundation, get on that team?
How did the guy who gave 36 grand to the Democratic Party get on the team?
Why would Mueller do that?
Who was crying at Hillary's? Because he's, I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt. He's so damn arrogant. He doesn't care about appearances. All of us have to be. Do you realize if a Republican did that, what the New York Times would have done? If I had been made special prosecutor for Hillary Clinton and I hired Ken Starr.
Good luck. Mr. Mayor, good to see you. I really do like the ring. I'm glad you had to pay for it, though.
I did.
That would have been a controversy.
And
tonight.
The three others.
Yeah. All right, when we come back, President Trump fed up with the illegal immigration crisis at our southern border. We've got the drastic actions. Michelle Malkin weighs on that. This will be a key issue in 99 days. Straight ahead.
Includes many other things. We have to end the lottery. We have to end the chain. The chain is like a disaster. You bring one person in, you end up with 32 people. We have to end these horrible catch and release principles where you catch somebody, you take their name and you release them. You don't even know who they are. And then they're supposed to come back to a court case where they want us to hire thousands of judges. The whole thing is ridiculous. And we have to change our laws, and we do that through Congress. So